It only takes one person to make a difference in the life of a child. When I look at this team of people that we put together every year, our full-time OPP members and the summer students that we hire, and I see how compassionate and how caring they are and what a difference that huge group of people can make on all of these kids and the impact that these kids have on each other. And I think it's just incredible when youth have opportunity to connect with who they are as Indigenous people and not feel shame or feel misunderstood or not see anybody around them who is like them. It really creates this space where they can just flourish.
Niigan's just like, it feels so like wild, if that makes sense, but like a good wild.
What do you mean by wild?
Like, it's like a fun, but like, it's also like very like spiritual in a way. And like, talk about like mature topics.
And why I tell my story and why it's really important for me to sit in a circle and tell you all is
things like that. It's unique in its own way, and that's why I think Niigan's a very amazing camp.
Do it!
Hashtag adventure!
Hashtag traditional.
Ooh.
Hashtag blast.
Just be in the culture. And our youth sometimes, it's the first time they're exposed to it, but it doesn't really feel that way.
At first it was nerve-wracking because I can be like a shy person at times, but like everyone was so welcoming. And so it made me feel like I like belonged. So, felt nice. I like it. I like the people here too.
Honestly, I feel great right now. It's a great place and I like being here, so. I'd come back for sure, yeah.
We started our day here this morning with a sunrise ceremony, and I came here this morning to start the ceremony at 6 o'clock. It's very important to pass our ceremonies and our teachings on to our youth, because I feel it's important what I tell you, you're going to tell your children, your grandchildren, and that knowledge goes on into the future. It's why I like doing it this way. I really enjoy being around youth and children for that reason. I really enjoy watching our young people learn and practice our culture. It's one of my favorite things.
Just the feeling of it when you're drumming, you can like actually feel like the vibrations, and then everybody's like dancing around you, everybody's happy. Just lightens up everybody's spirit. Yeah. And I just like to do it. Makes me feel proud.
And after 2 or 3 days, you can see the change in the students that are here. They're making some connection, whether it's just a simple smudge in the morning or sitting in the circle and speaking with everyone.
I really enjoy how like we all come together during like the teachings of like the traditional ways and stuff, and we're all kind of like participating and stuff like that. I also enjoy the fun things, like when we all go out swimming or playing manhunt or whatever, that's always fun.
It's insane. The feeling, it's nothing else. Possibly like one of the best things you could do.
It's good to be just in the place where people are learning, and our youth are really open-minded. They're looking for who they are, their identity, first as individuals, for their family and their nation. So I really enjoy that, their openness and the way they're, well, actually thirsty for knowledge and the way they absorb everything.
Everyone's given a gift in life, that you're going to do something extraordinary. And especially Indigenous youth, they have so many gifts that we're not using, and that we need to find those gifts. And we need to support them as they find those gifts. And I think when kids come here, they find that connection because they're sitting with all the youth from Northern Ontario. It's not just from their community. And when they share in that circle, they can hear everybody else is struggling with something also. But also about all those gifts that we've been given with the drum, the seven grandfather teachings, the medicine wheel teachings. It gives them the foundation to try better, to do better things in their communities.
I think really Niigan Mosewak is just, if I had to say one thing about it, it is a showcase of the resiliency of Indigenous youth, Indigenous leaders, and really building on that and finding pathways forward. And when I look at some of the kids that I was there with, like there's some kids now that are, you know, running education within their communities. There's some kids that were, that are now community leaders. And, I really consider a lot of them my friends. So from a personal level, I can't speak enough about it. And from a professional level, I think I was blessed and honored to be a part of it.